away from her?
Not walk away, back away. Turn and face her and back away. You call ear as you tap her towards her. Ear.
Ear.
Tap.
Ear.
Keep moving.
Ear. Ear.
Keep moving. Don't give up just because she has. See how she's defaulting?
Ear.
Okay. Start collecting your leash. Don't wrap it in your hands. Use both hands. Bring her in. Tap here.
Tap here.
Sit.
Sit.
Good girl. Very nice. And pay her off. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good dog. Shaky, shaky, pretty. Good dog. Don't let her get up. See how she's escaping?
Sit.
You're stopping. Did you stop tapping or were you continuing to tap after she sat?
No, I didn't tap.
Okay, so she looked like you were still tapping. Good girl. Very nice. Now, and this is really hard. It's very, very hard, especially for us chicks. Okay? Stop doing this. In your hand, pocket, so forth. Okay? So once your hands get familiar with where they need to be, all right? Okay? Because it's all about... Right. When we start escalating, this is what happens, okay? And with dogs, what happens when you do that is, again, it has to do with center of gravity, inertia, momentum, and all that stuff. In a situation with women, all of our power comes from above the knees, just above the hips. Above that, we start losing power exponentially. With dogs, a lot of times, for some stupid reason, people think they're holding an umbrella when it comes to handling the dog leash. When up here, you have no control. Then you've actually given the dog all of it. Keep your hands low toward your center of gravity. There's nothing the dog can take away from you. Alright? Both your hands. And that's why I said pants pockets, belt loops, waistbands, pants, something like that. Keep your hands low. This is where all the action is. You don't have to move your hands. Okay? When it comes to the collar, this is the other thing we can do. We need to set out. Look right. Bang, bang, bang. You don't want to do that. Okay? This is just like a cell phone, a TV remote, something that becomes a fixture of the dog's, light. Pocket. On your back. It shouldn't be something that the dog equates with what's happening. Okay? Yeah, that's why I don't like it. And unfortunately, it's the only collar that I have right now. I was going to give you the doctor, but it looks like the transmitter is not responding. It's not holding a charge, so I'm going to have to send you one with that. Why they sent that, I don't know. But when I get the other one, it's very, very easy.
I might have to hold it like this.
Well, see, Ashley, yeah, you may. These are actually pre-programmable, but it's like it takes an engineering degree.
I'll do it like that.
But as long as you know where your fingers are going.
Right.
And
so
that way you
besides
don't have to look at it.
Create a shock then?
No, it's not. Nothing creates a shock. All right, this is the pager function.
Right, so I don't know why.
She was just overreacting because they don't like it. Okay, I mean, she's functioning, again, this is on 5. All right, she's responding to a 5. All right, she's responding to a 5 on a mm-hmm. continual function. It's just out of there, it's not shocking, it's not pain, it's startling.
Okay, so
that's what it was. That's what was happening. I just hit it. That's the pager function. That's what was freaking her out.
Oh.
It's like the vibration.
She's hearing that. I see.
No. It has nothing to do with hearing. It's feeling. It's the vibration. Zzz.
Okay.
99.9% of all dogs.
So we don't have, but we don't have to do that.
No, you don't.
We shouldn't.
I'm
going to
show
her.
Which is the vibration?
This is the beeper. Hear it? Okay. This is the pager function. And this is the this is momentary, and this is continuous. And she wasn't overreacting to that.
So it's
at
basically
all.
Just these two
buttons. Buttons.
Right. So I was probably doing what you said, pushing
right.
this, and
probably
I was freaking out.
Because you were the way you were holding it.
Right. But I think it's easier for me to do the other one.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Just as long as it's just your shot.
I mean, I'm very. I,